Hi everyone, good evening. I'm Jayne at Rockin' Worms. Little shout out to my casting crew members. Yay! All right, so what I'm gonna show you tonight is I am splitting one of my nursery bins. These are bins that started off as cocoon bins. They've hatched. I've got tons of worms in these bins. And now I need to split them so the worms have more space, more real estate to grow up in, and also because I'm reducing the bin worm population by half, they'll also have less competition to get to the food. All of this is in order for the worms to get bigger, okay? Because eventually they're all gonna become breeders, and bigger breeders give me bigger cocoons. And I talked about the benefit of that in my breeding bin for success, module one. So if you haven't seen that module about why bigger breeders are your friend, please give that a look, and I'll link it in the description as well. Okay, so let's get into this bin. And I have found what I think is the easiest way to split bins, and I'm gonna share that with you. So this is the nursery bin. It's from March 25th. Which is 4 months ago, 3 and 4 or 7. Yeah, four months ago, okay? And let's take a look, see in here. So this is what I'm talking about. Lots of worms, and this isn't even the feed zone. This is the non-feed zone end of this bin. And why I am mixing this up is one, to aerate it. But since I'm going to be splitting this bin, I want to have, you know, sort of kind of an equal number-ish of worms staying put and the same general number going to the new bin. So by mixing them up, if I do have a preponderance of worms in what was the feed zone, which you can see there's like no food in there. It's hard to tell where the feed zone was. Here's a little piece of lettuce. They've been roaming the bin, it looks like, looking for food scraps. Okay, so again, I just want to mix this into the lower population end. All right, look at all these worms. Beautiful red wigglers, beautiful Essenia fetidas with, you know, their little yellow tail. No clotomes yet, because again, this is a nursery bin, but these worms are gonna be getting close soon. So again, another reason why I just wanna give them more room and more access to feed so they can finish maturing for me. Okay, so that's pretty good. Okay, so that's my nursery bin. Now over here next to it, I have the new bin that half of those worms are gonna go into. And I put in, oh, came off my glove, look at that. I'm gonna put him here even though he's gonna end up going back in, just so he doesn't get, you know, mixed in here. All right, so this is my standard bedding, tabletop pre-compost bedding with sifted cow manure in. It is already moistened. See the moisture on my glove, a little bit squish, right? You know, breaks apart, not super easy, but easy enough, okay? So I wanted to have a good moisture level, especially since they're coming out of a higher moisture bin. I don't want them going into, you know, lack of moisture shock, but I do want to start using less moist bedding than they're used to. And that's again because I'm going to be sifting out as these become a grow out bin as opposed to a nursery bin. All right, so now what I'm going to do is simply kind of, you know, eyeball it here, and if I make the cut, it makes it easier for me to keep it halvesies. All right, so really complicated stuff here, guys. I'm just picking them up and putting them in. Okay. Now there's every reasonable expectation that in another couple of months, I might have to split this bin again, because there are still a lot of worms in the amount of space I'm giving them in my standard bins, okay? But you know, one step at a time. Let's get them into a better environment for them right now. And then when they need to be dealt with again, moved again, I can assess the situation and make a decision there. Some of these worms, by the time I come back and think, maybe I have to split the bin, maybe I have worms that have matured into breeders, and I'm gonna pull those out and put them into a breeder bin, and that may give enough space in these bins that I don't have to split it again, if you kind of follow that progression. Okay, so here they are, split done. Now, this is, you know, the bedding mix. It has a lot of biota in it, but I want to encourage them to come over into this end. So I'm going to give them a feed. I forgot to grab a napkin. Hold on a second. Here's a napkin. It rips this way. Okay. Here's a napkin. I'm going to give them two because there are still a lot of worms in there. Okay. And now I'm going to give them a feed. This is going to be pumpkin that's been previously frozen, defrosted, and I squeeze the living you know what out of it, because while I want moisture in my bin, like I said, I'm trying to keep my bin bedding a little bit drier than I normally have in the past in order to facilitate sifting down the road. So there's still plenty of moisture in these vegetables. So squeezing them out is not hurting anything as far as the ability of the worms to eat the food, but it will make sifting for me a little bit easier down the road. A little bit of worm chow. There we go. Worm chow, by the way, is a good way to fatten up your worms. We talked about that, why you want fat worms. In the other video I mentioned at the beginning, this is vegetable powder, which is not super fattening because it literally is 100% vegetable. So overall lower calories than the worm chow is, which is made up of flour and oatmeal, crackers, you know, whatever I've got in my pantry that perhaps is a little too stale for me to enjoy eating it. That was azomite. And here's a little agricultural lime. Okay, so squish that up a little bit. So my dry ingredients like my vegetable powder and my worm chow don't get too clumpy. And now I'm going to add in a nice topping of more of my bedding, and that's going to seal in odors so it doesn't attract any bugs to my worm bin, because I don't want that. And we're good to go. So one bin down. Actually, you know what? Let me put the paper on and then I really am done. There's the paper and here is the plastic. All right, so this bin really is done, except I will put a label on it telling myself what I did. This is the remaining worm population from the nursery. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put in the layer of bedding. I'm going to get another napkin. Let's see if one or two come out. Looks like two again, which is fine. Settle that in a little bit. Rinse and repeat. What did I do with the food? Did I give them all the food? Oh, okay. Guess what? I gave all the food to the other worm bin, or to the other nursery bin. So I'm going to stop the video here because I am really rinsing and repeating, and I'm gonna go out to the refrigerator where I have more of my frozen foods defrosting so I can squeeze them out and come back and put them in this worm bin with the worm chow and the amendments, cover it up, back on the shelf it goes, and the worms can continue to grow into big, healthy, happy red wigglers. So all I ask is, if you're not yet a member of the castings crew, consider joining by simply hitting that subscribe button. I will see you on the next video. I hope you have a good evening. I am yours in the dirt, Jayne.